A family in Tate County wants answers from Governor Haley Barbour after being told he pardoned the man they say killed their loved one. 16 WAPT's Aaron Kelly is live in the newsroom to explain why they say this man should never be out of prison, no matter who he worked for. Aaron.
According to MDOC records, Scott Joseph Osmond had been serving a life sentence for murder, conspiracy, and armed robbery, and he'd been serving it at the governor's mansion. He'd been in prison for more than 17 years, and now the family of victim Ricky Montgomery says they're devastated to hear Osmond is being released from prison.
It was December 1992 that family members say 33-year-old store clerk Ricky Montgomery was murdered on the job in DeSoto County. Joseph Osmond was convicted of murder, armed robbery, and conspiracy, and sentenced to life in prison. But Saturday, Montgomery's nephew says his mother got a call from the Department of Corrections saying Governor Haley Barbour pardoned Osmond.
Well, of course, it's devastating. You know, we go through this, and it's reliving it and hashing it over again and again when I don't think the general public has an idea that of the things that these convicts are doing.
Mark McAbee's mother wrote to the Department of Corrections 2 years ago, outraged to learn Osmond had been assigned to work at the governor's mansion. MDOC said he met all the requirements and went through an extensive screening process. Now the McAbees say the pardon means a hardcore criminal is getting a clean slate.
Well, we have people out here on the streets that are sex offenders that have to register. This man killed somebody. This man took somebody's life, and it's not even going to indicate on any paperwork.
Law professor Matt Steffi says while it's not clear why Barbour pardoned Osmond, he sees a pattern.
Oh, it is certainly consistent with the practice he's followed with pardons so far. What it appears that all of these criminal defendants have in common is that they did odd jobs or somehow worked around the governor's mansion in some fashion pursuant to a program at the Department of Corrections.
Steffi says with Barbour leaving office, political fallout for now is minimal. The McAbees say they'll fight to change laws to ensure other families don't get that same call.
Now, we called the governor's spokesperson as well as chief of staff. We also called a spokesperson for the Department of Corrections. No one has called us back tonight. Live in the newsroom, Aaron Kelly, 16 WAPT News.
Thanks a lot, Aaron.